Debbie Wicker is a licensed broker and team leader with Keller Williams Loudoun Gateway and has been helping clients buy and sell homes in Northern Virginia for over 30 years. Debbie can also be seen on the TV program American Dream that showcases real estate in Loudoun County. On the show, Debbie has the pleasure of highlighting neighborhoods, places of interest, and real estate listings in Loudoun. Debbie also supports two children's charities, which hold a special place in her heart: Children's Miracle Network, which funds children's hospitals throughout the U.S., and Smile Train, which provides cleft palate surgeries for impoverished children worldwide. Cathy Howell is a top producing agent at Keller Williams. As a longtime resident of Northern Virginia, Cathy specializes in relocating clients to Virginia as well as helping clients relocate across the country. Cathy has built a successful business on referrals. Debbie, why don't we start out with you? How's the current situation with the pandemic affected the local real estate market as a whole?
That's a great question. At the beginning of the year, the market was really strong. We had multiple contracts on properties, rocking and rolling through the first 4 or 5 days. And, you know, sellers get to cherry pick whichever offer they wanted to work with. Then came the sheltering in place and the pandemic hit full force. I think it was about the second weekend in March. And literally from Friday night to Monday morning, everything just came to a screeching halt. And people weren't really sure what was going to happen with the economy, what was going to happen with the market. A lot of stuff just dried up almost overnight. And fast forward about 10 days, and everyone sort of woke up and had coffee and said, okay, we'll figure out how to work this thing. And it was off to the races again. Right now, we've put a few safety precautions in place, and we have pretty much the same market we had at the beginning of the year. It is a very strong seller's market. And from my experience in the last 100 days, with that one little exception of that 10-day point in time where it was very slow, multiple offers, houses don't last more than 3, 4, 5 days on the market max. And the interest rates have certainly helped our local market to stay nice and robust.
Cathy, you're seeing the same thing, I assume.
I am seeing the same thing. I've had a slightly different experience than Debbie in that my specialty is a senior real estate specialist. So while I do a lot of different things, my priority is 55 plus buyers. So logically, my market took a very different turn. It shut down for quite a bit longer out of fear and concern for staying safe. And some of my communities even shut down as well. And as you know, even the 55 plus stuff with Van Meter, we had to make appointments. So I'm just seeing a resurgence probably in the last 2 weeks. During the downtime, I still had people inquiring about homes, but were very concerned about safety. And because of the safety steps that Van Meter's put into place, I actually do have people starting to drive in from out of state. I have appointments to start showing because people still need a place to live. And they're seeing that the inventory is very low and they want to get that perfect home for it because it's their forever home.
Yes. Now, talking about that active adult buyer, that's the high risk category. It seems to be not a surprise at all to me that they would be a little less anxious to come out of the hole, so to speak.
They have been very anxious. I've done a lot of video walkthroughs, and it's nice partnering with agents like Debbie who can take safety precautions to sell the home that they're in while I focus on safely helping them buy a home. And what's nice for them about the new construction right now is that they have time. So they don't feel rushed, and we can do the planning process. And I think that's very important for them because they're still not sure where this is all going.
Now, with Van Meter, I know we've been using virtual tours and Matterports and all of the new technologies that are available to us. I assume it's the same on the resale end.
It very much is. Actually, we've been utilizing the virtual open houses as one option, especially when we were all first sheltering in place and we had, you know, a fair amount of uncertainty. Open houses, the traditional style open house with inviting multiple people through the house in, you know, a 2 or 3 hour stretch, that came to a screeching halt. And so we went to a virtual process where we would schedule time with the seller and block that from any showings and literally go into the house and pretend as though I am doing a showing with a particular buyer and, you know, talk to the camera and tell people about this great opportunity that's out there. And it was well received. I think we're just now starting to go back to the traditional open house, but with lots of precautions in place, of course. We are asking everyone to please wear a mask or a bandana over your nose and your mouth. Don't touch anything inside the house. We've got booties, the shoe covers that we ask people to please put on while they're in the house and then take them with you when you leave, so we don't have used shoe covers laying around. And we ask that only the agent who is actually showing the house be the one to touch the doorknobs going into and outside of the house, so that when the sellers come home, they can wipe down some doorknobs with some wipes and feel relatively safe. And of course, I would limit those groups to three or less, the agent and one or two buyers with them.
How much of this strong market that we're experiencing now is due to the fact that folks are reluctant to put their house on the market to list it?
But that's a lot of it right there. I have a lot of times I work with people anywhere from a few weeks to often up to 2 years as they plan their next steps. And I went through all of my clients who are planning to buy and sell in the next 6 months to a year. And a lot of them decided to wait and see what was happening. So there's a lot of homes just waiting for people who are ready to move on to the next home, but they're not quite sure how to approach it. And I guess what I would have to say is, the protocols are in place and we've seen great success on the buy and sell side. And anybody who puts their house on the market during this period is going to do well. I personally put my own house on the market a month ago, sold it in 12 hours for top dollar, and I'm off to my next home.
That's awesome.
All right. I have time for one more question, and it might be loaded with dynamite. I don't know.
Bring it on.
You have somebody who's thinking about buying a house. Should they wait until all this is over or should they go right now?
I know the answer to that one, and that is full speed ahead, baby. Jump in. The interest rates are at historic lows. And what I've been saying to all of our clients is I have no idea what the market's going to look like in October, November. Right now, I can tell you the interest rates are at historic lows and who knows when that will change. So jump in and find that house, baby. It's a great time.
Debbie Wicker, Cathy Howell from Keller Williams, thank you so very much for spending a little time with us today.
Thanks, sir. We appreciate
it. We do indeed. Take care. Thanks again.